は15歳の時、自分の道を決めました。僕は夢を叶えるためにこの表を作りました。これが僕の目標でした。可動域、奥行きをイメージ、スピード、仲間を思いやる心、感謝、これが僕の目標です。あなたの目標は何ですか？
Hi everybody, it's Book Shambi. Welcome to the show.
From inside Lone Depot Park in Miami, Florida, the show brings you a matchup of division rivals. It's the New York Mets taking on the Miami Marlins. Alongside Chris Singleton, I'm John Shambi, and a big-time win streak is on the line today, Chris.
No one's really sure how much a manager impacts wins and losses over the course of the season, but I'll say right now, this manager has been making all the right moves.
about to get started here. Now the starting pitcher in this one, Trevor Rogers.
Well, he got into the eighth inning his last time out, really pitching deep into games as of late. We'll see today how many innings he's got in him.
Okay, all set to go. And now, Luis Guillorme.
Leading off the afternoon for the Mets, the second baseman, Luis
the pitch.
Guillorme.
Line to left, just inside the line, and it's down for a knock. Now he turns and heads for second. The throw in, safe at second with a leadoff double.
You know, I was watching his rounds during batting practice today. So impressed with his ability to let the ball travel, go back up the middle and the other way. Sometimes when you step in the box during the game, you get a little anxious and you get away from that. But so far, I've seen him stay consistent with his pregame preparation.
One out in the top of the first. And now it's the polar bear, Pete Alonso. 3-for-8 in the series coming in. First pitch doesn't find the zone. And it's second. Foul ball there. Bounce to the right. Throws to first, and that takes care of Alonso. Now it's Dominic Smith.
The right fielder, number two, Dominic Smith.
That one's in there, 0-1.
Well, the best way to shake off yesterday's struggles is to get on the board early. They've got a guy in scoring position. They've got to find a way here to get him in.
No score yet, but a runner at third with two away. Out to short. To first, and that'll do it. Mets lead one. Now the Marlins will see what they can do. No score. You're watching. Bottom of the first. And on the hill, Taijuan Walker. Singing, he's kind of a road warrior, yeah?
Leading off.
I definitely say so. You know, some guys shrink a little bit on the road. They're so used to just, you know, having the comforts of being at home and having the fans behind them. But this guy seems to thrive in adversity and being in some hostile environment. So when you have a player like this on your team that goes out there and competes, you definitely like your chances away from your home ballpark.
High fly ball out of the left center field. Nimmo racing over to make the catch.
Batting second.
And time now for the Marlins lineup. They've had a great year offensively, as good an offensive team as you will find.
They're deep, first and foremost, but the way that they can manipulate their personnel for matchups and everything else, it's very intelligent the way that they use their team. And I think it creates a little bit of uncertainty for opposing teams, especially in a big game, big series.
Next offering is fouled back. The wind and the pitch. And a count 1-2.
He was a little out front, but did a good job keeping the hands back long enough to foul that pitch off.
That one ran inside, almost got him.
Straightened him up a little bit.
And a pitch. Swing and a miss. The velocity blasted it right past him. Two outs, bases empty. Jazz Chisholm now. Two for six so far in the series.
Second baseman.
Foul ball.
Chisholm.
Righty to the plate. And a swing and a miss.
Let's see if he's willing to use the whole field right here. Definitely pounding him away.
And down on strikes he goes. That's the third out. Second inning set to go. And here is Eduardo Escobar. First pitch just misses.
Eduardo Escobar.
And that's in for a strike.
One ball, two strikes.
Next offering is fouled back. The 1-2. And now 2-2.
I got to count 2-2.
On a line, base hit. And the leadoff man aboard.
That's about as textbook as it gets. Got his stride low, out of the way early. He stayed in.
Here comes the pitch. Runner breaks for second. And it's through for a hit. Throw comes in. Runner stopped. Second and third. Nobody out.
Well, no waiting around right there. He was ready to swing it on the first pitch. Just a simple ground ball the other way. They had eyes on it, man. Sometimes that's all you need to do. Just let the ball travel, put the ball in play, and just hope it finds a hole.
To the plate. Save. And it's 1-0. Here's Brandon Nimmo.
The center fielder, number 9. Brandon.
And he grounds one to the right side. Sends it to first. Runner scores, though. That's a little insurance, and the lead is 2. Tomas Nito with the plate. First pitch, and that's in for a strike. And a foul ball. On the ground to the left. That's a base hit. And that turns the lineup over.
He needed that one. It's been a tough stretch at the plate lately. There's nothing cheap about the way he got that one through the infield. That was ripped. Caught out in front and didn't get on.
The throw in time to get him. And that does. Welcome back. And now it's Juan Soto.
Leading up for the Marlins.
Yeah, the right hander back to work. That one to first.
Soto.
He'll do it himself. One up, one down. And now the first baseman, Ty France. And there's a rocket into the outfield. So a man aboard now with one away.
Went up there looking to be aggressive and got something he could handle. At 110 miles per hour on the exit velo, that thing was screaming. And that's some serious bat speed to generate contact like that. And no doubt a higher launch angle sends that thing out of here easily. And you can feel this crowd waking up a bit here as the guys are starting to make some noise with their bats.
Austin Meadows takes a strike there as he stands at the plate now. The 0-1. France at first, one gone. Next one misses, and a count 2-1. Righty delivers. That one hit to right. Smith drifts towards it. And there's two away.
This lineup's going to have to find a way to make him work a little harder out there on the mound. I mean, he is just mowing him down. He's settling in. You got to make him uncomfortable. Maybe step out of the box, call timeout, do whatever it takes.
Josh Bell takes a ball here as he stands in now. That one the other way. Lindor, off balance throw, in time. Inning over. On to the third inning, and now the DH, Jeff McNeil.
Leading off for the Mets.
First offering misses the mark.
Jeff McNeil.
The big lefty turns, kicks, deals. And a foul ball. On the ground at first. He steps on the bag. One up, one down.
Now
so digging in, Pete Alonso. Tons of pop. Right now he's third in the National League in homers. And that's in there for strike one.
Well, he looks fresh out there. Just needs to get a little more confidence and remember how good he's been in the past.
That one not close. And it's 2-1. The wind of the pitch. Little bouncer out in front of the plate. And he beats the throw very close right there. And it looks like they might end up challenging this one. So they have decided to challenge the play, and now it's up to the replay umpires in New York to make the call.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Marlins.
Here's one more look. They called him safe, and I'm not sure that there's anything here to overturn the call. What about you, Singy?
I don't think so, Boog. I mean, we need something obvious to overturn it, and I just don't see it.
So they've made a decision, and the runner is safe. Not enough to overturn it. Dom Smith stands in. In there, and it's 0-1. Just missed. And a pitch. Runner on the go. And that one wrapped foul. The punch out there. That's out number two. Eduardo Escobar, El Caballo up to hit.
Now batting.
That one's in there, 0-1.
Eduardo.
And down the lefty. Swing and a miss.
The baseball's coming out of his hand very well. He's been able to paint all four corners, but really good ride at the top of the zone. Hitters have to respect that. Very difficult pitch to hit.
The next offering misses. And a count, 1-2. Two outs. Good eye right there. Ripped to short. Cruz handles. Tosses the first. Escobar out on the play. And that.
Leading off for the Marlins. The designated.
And
hitter.
Downstairs.
Sanchez.
And another ball.
When you get ahead in the count, there's no doubt that the success rate goes up. And that's what he's been doing. It's made a big impact for him in recent games.
That one missed. Now 3-0.
Well, I would expect in this 3-0 count, you're taking all the way. See if he'll walk you.
Towards first. And he grabs it in foul ground. Right-hander kicks, deals. Fought off foul. The pitch in the air, center field. Nimmo drifts towards it. One away.
Batting ninth, the catcher, Wilson Ramos.
First pitch, and that's in for a strike. One down, base is empty. Strike on the outside corner, and it's 0-2.
Love how vocal the umpire is today. No doubt in the hitter's mind, catcher's mind, and even the pitcher's mind as to the conviction in the call.
Just a slow ground ball this time. Gets it to first. Two up, two down. John Birdie at the plate.
Third baseman, number five, John Birdie.
And the first pitch misses for ball one.
You want to be patient here. Try to work a walk if you can. You've got a big power bat behind you in the on-deck circle. And with two outs, one swing, puts you right back in this ballgame.
And that one fouled off. One and two here. This to third. Escobar picks it up. Slings it across. Play made. That ends the inning. Back here at Lone Depot Park, John Ciampi with Chris Singleton. And set to lead off the fourth, Mark Canna. And a strike in there.
0-1.
Next offering is in for a strike. And down on strikes. And one out now. Francisco Lindor comes up to the plate.
Up next for the Mets.
And that's in there for strike one.
Francisco Lindor.
The wide to kick the pitch. That misses. Ball two. And he deals. That misses. And the count is 3-1. And here it comes. And that's ball four.
Maybe a little loss of focus on the mound right there. Pretty much gifted him first base with a quick free pass.
Lindor the move. Tag. Safe. Ramos throw too late.
Well, we all know this team is struggling right now, and sometimes you just got to do something different to generate some offense. A little more aggressive right there to put the pressure on the opponent. We'll see if it pays off on the scoreboard for these guys.
Got him. Two out. So he gets the call and picks up the strikeout looking.
Sometimes with a good hitter at the plate, he'll be the one to get the benefit of the doubt if he lays off on a close pitch like that, but just not right there. Strike zone definitely expanded a little bit with two strikes.
Next offering is in for a strike. That to right. He gets there to make the play. A nice running grab. And that is the inning. Mets strand one, but they hold the 2-0. Back here at the ballpark, here's O'Neill Cruz. Walker back to work. Takes low for ball one.
Walt certainly doing his very best out there on the mound to bring that win streak to a halt.
Next pitch is outside. Kicks and fires. Line drive. Makes the catch. One down. Now here's the second baseman, Chisholm. Hit on the ground to the right side. And it goes just foul. The pitch. Ball one there.
Just missed with that backdoor breaking ball. If he gets a swing and miss or called strike, 0-2 count. Instead, it's 1-1. Look for him to go back to that pitch later in this at bat.
That one back up the middle and it gets through.
Now back.
Here's Juan Soto.
Dominant performance for him today, Boo. Just two hits allowed so far. No runs across either. And he's had an answer for just about every hitter he's faced. So I don't think this hit is going to knock him off his stride too much.
The 1-0. There's a strike. Ball to strike. There's a strike.
He must have been looking for something else because he gave up on that pitch a little early. It was right down Main Street. Probably not going to see a better pitch to hit in this at bat.
Next offering way off the plate. Got him looking. And there are two outs.
Well, definitely a borderline pitch right there, and he didn't look too convinced as he headed back to the dugout. Those are tough ones to let go as a hitter, but with the human umpire calling balls and strikes, it's always going to be on you to protect yourself with two strikes.
So up next, Ty France. And that one is lifted in the air. Nimmo moving under it, brings it in for the third out. Marlins leave one. Back here in Miami, we go to the top of the fifth. And stepping in for New York, Luis Guillorme. That's in there. That's strike one. And a pitch. And a swing and a miss there.
That pitch started in and ended up on the outside edge. Just changing planes and very difficult, especially for a left-handed hitter to track.
Cruz makes the catch. And there's one down.
The batter, number one.
And now here's Jeff McNeil.
Jeff McNeil.
That one off the bad part of the bat, just a lazy fly ball. Chisholm makes the play, and there's two away.
That's a really nice play, ranging back into the outfield for that catch. We all know those can be a little tricky, especially if the wind's swirling around out there.
Alonso stands in now and watches strike one. Next offering is in for a strike. Pretty good job on the mound in this one, Siggy. It feels like we've seen a lot of off-balance swings.
Yep, just one free pass, and obviously he's not a big strikeout guy, but he gets soft contact and he gets outs.
Next offering misses. It's 2-2. That one missed.
That's a really good take right there. Slider down and in. Very difficult to get on the same plane and do anything with.
Got him. And good work there as he gets a 1-2-3. Down in order, go to Mets. And welcome back. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. And now for the Marlins, Austin Meadows. And there's a fly ball deep right field. And it's gone! Austin Meadows powers one out of here. His 14th of the year. It's 2-1.
That pitch was intended to stay inside, but it leaked out over the middle of the plate. Hitter waited on it, and he connected just perfectly.
And now the switch hitting first baseman, Josh Bell.
Now batting, center fielder, Josh.
Bounced up the middle.
Bell.
Lindor on to first. And that's the first out in the bottom of the fifth. Jesus Sanchez, the next up for the Marlins. He's 0-1. And first offering is fouled off. The pitch. And a foul ball. That hits the dirt. 1-2 to count. And the right-hander deals. Got him looking. Two away. Two outs, base is empty. Wilson Ramos comes up to hit.
The catcher, number 40, Wilson.
And he swings and misses, and it's nothing at one.
Well, he's been incredibly efficient in this one. First pitch strike percentage over 70%. That's well above league average, and that's what's allowed him to pitch well up until this point.
Here's the 0-2. And down on strikes he goes. And that's the third out. One for the Marlins on the solo shot. And it's now a 2-1 ball game. New inning getting started. Now at the plate, Dominic Smith.
Leading off for the Mets, the right fielder, number 2.
Rolled over to third.
Dominic Smith.
Tosses to first, and that's one out as they get the leadoff hitter in the sixth.
Now batting.
And now here is Eduardo Escobar.
Escobar.
Ground ball, left side, and foul ball.
Well, on the mound, very efficient, able to produce an outcome, it seems like, within the third or fourth pitch of just about every at bat.
That one's sizzling on its way through to the outfield. So they get a man aboard with a one-out single.
Really nice job staying up the middle with his approach. He didn't try to do too much with the pitch. Just shot it through the infield.
Here's Mark Canna. In there for strike one. Escobar leads off first with one away. Pitch misses. And the count even 1-1. Swings through that one.
Well, the hitter shows the pitcher that he's willing to go after that pitch down in the zone. So perhaps he'll come back to it. Still try to get that ground ball double play.
They get it in quickly. So first and second, now one out. Now up to hit, up next, Francisco Lindor. He's 0-1.
Francisco Lindor.
In there, and it's 0-1. Runners at first and second with one gone. Ground ball right side, could be two. Chisholm over to second, not in time at first. It's a fielder's choice.
Well, that's great hustle out of the box to get down the line, knowing that a double play will end the inning. Good job at the finish, reaching out for the bag. Now they got runners on the corners and still an opportunity to pick up some runs.
And next for the Mets, Brandon Nimmo. First pitch, and he just misses.
If he can get through this one, put up a zero, this will help in his outings to come.
And there's the strike. Runners on first and third, two away. That one ripped. Bell puts it away, and that is that. Top of the order. Bottom of the sixth. Here's the third baseman, John Birdie.
Leading up.
Walker back to work.
The third baseman.
First pitch swinging.
That split is a pretty nasty 30. Pitch. Explodes out of the hand. Looks like a fastball, and the bottom just falls out of it.
Next one is off the play, and it's a ball and a strike. And the pitch. This one in the air, right field. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And there's one down. O'Neill Cruz, the next up for the Marlins. Ripped on the ground to second. On to first. And that quickly, two away. Jazz Chisholm, the next up for the Marlins.
Second baseman, Jazz
Chisholm. First pitch doesn't find the zone. Two down, nobody on. And now this one's a rocket to right. Way back there. Gone. Home run number 20 on the year, and we are starting over. It's 2-2.
That's exactly the pitch he was looking for. Crushes it and hits it out of the ballpark.
Now the youngster Juan Soto.
The batter, the right fielder.
Swings through that one, 0-1.
Soto.
And that's downstairs and outside. The 1-2. That one ripped, but foul. Left-hand hitter waits. And a swing and a miss. And that's that. Just one hit in the inning, but it was a big one right here as it ties the ball game. 2-2 game. All set for the start of the inning. And now the catcher comes up.
Leading off for the Mets, the catcher.
Now here's Tyler Rogers out of the pen. 25th appearance of the year for him.
They know that he can get a right-hander out, but he's in position to face a couple of lefties this inning.
Meadows on the move. Makes the grab on the run. And there's one down.
Just pulled off of it a little bit right there. That front shoulder coming open instead of staying closed. If he does that, he's going to be able to go up the middle the other way with some authority instead of a fly out to left.
Here's a high chopper. France picks it up, and they put the tag on him for the out. Jeff McNeil stands in.
For the Mets, the designated hitter, Jeff.
First offering misses the mark. Right-handed reliever. In the air, left field. Meadows makes the catch, and that'll do it. Back here at Lone Depot Park. And here's the first baseman, Ty France.
The first baseman.
First offering misses badly for ball one. Bullpen activity starting up now. Carlos Carrasco up and loosening in the pen. Peterson, the lefty, warming up as well. That's towards center. Nimmo has a beat on it. And a quick out number one. Now it's Austin Meadows. One for two.
Austin Meadows.
And the first pitch misses for ball one. That one is absolutely belted. And foul as it bangs off the fence. Left-hand batter waits. Uh-oh, that got him. And the potential winning run is aboard.
Well, he's just glad that he got hit with an off-speed pitch there instead of a fastball. Man, that would have hurt a lot more if it had velocity.
Yeah.
Out towards right center field. This one's got a chance. Gone! He made him pay for that one. It's his eighth home run of the year. And now they're out front. It's 4-2.
high fastballs, especially with good velocity, can be really hard to catch up to. But he stays tall, his top hand works extremely well, and he absolutely clobbered it.
Manager out of the dugout now, and it looks like we'll see a change on the mound. Taiwan Walker won't go any further. Two-run ball game as he heads for the dugout, and we'll be back with a new pitcher. Carlos Carrasco takes over on the mound. He's being eased into the game here with the bases empty. Now it's the DH, Jesus Sanchez. And he swings and misses at the initial offering. Still only one out here in the inning. Next pitch misses, and the count is 1-1. And the righty deals. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. At the belt and fires. And a ball evens the count. And now the count filled up 3-2. Here comes a pitch. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk. How big a deal is that walk?
I don't think it's a big deal because now if you pitch to the previous hitter with the power he has, you can hit a home run. I think it was a calculated walk. We'll see how it pays off here.
Sanchez, the base runner at first with one out. Next pitch downstairs and 1-1. Right-hander kicks, deals, and that one is lifted in the air. That skips over the fence, so it's an automatic double.
The automatic double took that decision out of the hands of the third base coach, didn't it? I mean, was he planning to send him home? We don't know, maybe, but now he's preparing for a whole different situation with a pair of runners in scoring position.
Here's a speed threat, John Birdie. And now a bunt, but it's a foul ball.
Here's a sack fly situation, and he's got to make sure he gets the ball out over the plate and get those arms extended. They're trying to crowd him with the infield in. This would be a big pickup if he can push a run across.
Alonso collects, steps on the bag for one. The tag, and that's out number three, inning over. But two come across to score in the inning, courtesy of this two-run homer. It's now 4-2. Ready to begin the eighth, and stepping in for New York, Pete Alonso.
Leading off for the Mets.
That's in there. Strike one.
Alonso.
And a swing and a miss.
Two really good back-to-back sliders. Now in an 0-2 count, he's feeling real confident about finishing this hitter off. He can go anywhere he wants.
Next offering is fouled back. And a pitch. Swing and a miss, and he got him. And he's down on strikes for the second time today.
Well, that's the moneymaker right there. Two strikes, slider down and away from a same side thrower as the hitter. I mean, it's just tough. You're looking to protect with two strikes and very difficult to lay off.
Eduardo Escobar getting ready to hit. First pitch doesn't find the zone. And he deals. He swings and fouls one off. And a ball and two strikes. Right side. Chisholm handles the chance. Throw to first is in time. Escobar out of the play. And the Mets go 1-2-3. Back here at the ballpark, bottom of the eighth. And at the plate for Miami, O'Neill Cruz.
Not shortstop.
The right-hander back to work. That's off the mark. And that is ball one. Swing and a ball hammered left field back there.
leaps at the wall, but can't haul it in. It bangs off the wall. Safely into third with a leadoff triple. Stepping in, Jazz Chisholm. Siggy, he's got a history of coming through in the big spots. I know I like to talk about, I'm not sure whether clutch actually exists, but you look at the numbers, and this guy always seems to deliver in those spots. And first offering is fouled off.
Well, I think it's the ability to assess the situation, understanding what the pitcher has, what he's trying to get people out on, and then being able to use the entire field.
Canna sizing this one up. Racing makes the catch. Runner tags for home. Throw is offline, and he scores. And they lead by three.
Well, he's always capable of losing one over the fence. He might have just missed it right there, but a good job driving that run from third.
Juan Soto now. Back to the mound. Gathers and throws to first. They get the out on Soto. Two outs, base is empty. Ty France will hit next. And first offering is fouled off. That one drifts inside. Action in the Mets bullpen. Tommy Hunter appears to be getting loose. Righty delivers. Next offering is outside. Kicks and deals. And it's fouled away. Two outs. And now it's filled up. Three, two. Line drive. He's got it. And that'll end the inning. We go to the ninth. Here's the left fielder, Mark Canna.
Leading off for the Mets, the left fielder, Mark Canna.
Now time is called here. Pitching coach on his way out to the mound. The pitch. Out to short. Cruz collects it. Whips it to first. Now one gone in the ninth. And now it's Frankie Lindor.
Francisco Lindor.
Pitch misses inside. 1-0. Right-handed reliever. Swing and a base hit. And that's going to get into the corner. Makes the turn and heads for second. And he's in ahead of the throw with a double.
Showed some really nice patience in that at bat. Worked himself into a good count. He got a pitch he could get to out front, kept his bat through the ball, and didn't pull off or roll his hands over. And that allowed him to rip that ball down the line for the double.
They turn things over to the southpaw, Josh Hader. This southpaw's been really good against left-handed hitters.
Well, I think that what makes him so tough against left-handers is he hides the ball for a long time. And from that same side, harder for you to determine which part of the plate it's going to end up on.
Swings through that one for strike two. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And now two gone.
Well, when you throw the same pitch back to back, that's how you want to do it. Set him up in the strike zone, then extend a little bit from there and see if you can get him to chase. Nicely done with the slider right there.
Nito at the plate with two away. Swings through that one. Next offering is in for a strike.
That slider breaking in could be a tricky pitch. If you don't finish it and have that bite at the end and it stays out over the plate, it can get hit a long way. But that was a good one right there.
Next one misses. Two balls, two strikes to count with two outs. And a swing and a miss, and that is the ball game.
Well, just another big win today, and everyone is jumping on board behind this ball club. They're playing so well, they're packing the stands, and it's just an exciting brand of baseball. We'll see how far it goes, but right now, no one thinks it's going to end anytime soon.
And your final score, 5-2. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Shambi. We'll see you soon.
seriously. Everything's circular. Beginning with end of us. I can tell by that look in your face when you look in our eyes that you're really just scared of us. The new breed coming down that mountain. We ain't afraid of no team.
Here now is our final line score for this afternoon. First, for the victorious Miami Marlins. 5 runs, 7 hits, no errors. They left 4 men on base. For the Mets,